welcome to day two. So now we are heading to breakfast. I didn't have breakfast yet, but I brushed my teeth ages ago.
One of the strange sights on board the trams of Amsterdam is this: the customer service counter. Oh, by the way, where exactly are we going?
What will we do after breakfast? So, after breakfast, we'll go to the Van Gogh Museum.
Do you guys notice the houses in Amsterdam are quite unique and different from what I see in London?
They look rectangular, like high rectangle, small rectangle, another small rectangle, and they are stuck together, and they are slanted.
Why are the houses in Amsterdam wonky? I will tell you the reason later. Stay tuned.
Okay, guys. I have finished the breakfast now, so we are going inside the Van Gogh Museum.
The Van Gogh Museum contains the largest collection of Van Gogh's paintings and drawings in the world. In 2017, the museum had 2.3 million visitors and was the most visited museum in the Netherlands. The Rietveld building is the main structure and houses the permanent collection. Let's explore Van Gogh's masterpieces.
I'm listening to this thing. You can't hear it. You can only hear if you're wearing a headset.
Vincent Van Gogh was born on March 30th, 1853 in the Netherlands. During his lifetime, Van Gogh created about 2,100 pieces of art, 860 of which were oil paintings. Most of them were done in the last 2 years of his life. Because he couldn't afford to pay models, Van Gogh would initially paint flowers, landscape, and himself. Look, this is the famous sunflower painting. Sunflowers is a powerful painting, using just three tints of yellow and nothing else. Van Gogh achieved a glorious harmony of colors. Unfortunately, Van Gogh suffered from mental illness and cut off his left ear when tempers flared with Paul Gauguin. Sadly, he committed suicide at the age of 37. Although he was dying young, his bold use of color, expressive line, and thick application of paint inspired many artists. In this museum, you can not only see the painting, but smell and touch it.
Smell of the painting or flower. Oh, it smells so good. Feel the 19th century fragrant cold, hot. Except this part. That's a protection. I can draw something like that.
Okay, guys, the next location is definitely a place of Baba's obsession. Actually, I really have no idea what in the world is Skuwakzai. Gangsters, right? Okay, let's see what happened. Oh my god! What? Oh no! Oh no! What is he gonna do? More gunshots? Where's the police? Where are they? Oh Oh no, run, run! Oh my god, he jumps into the river! Anyway guys, this is the place, Amsterdam Chinatown. And we have our lunch here at Hoi Xing Dai Zhao Lao.
Okay, so now we are in Chinese restaurant and we're waiting for a ticket to get in. Bob, I have a question. Is this where the film was filmed? Okay, now it's time to eat this one. Ham soy gok. Crunchy.
Wugok.
I think it's rice inside there, and this is a leaf covered. Bigger than my hand. After our yummy lunch, we decided to explore the city. Oh, watch out! Beware of the bicycles here, they are speedy. And guess what we find here?
Wait, it's
marijuana ice cream, and it costs 7 euro. Expensive. Of course, I didn't try, and Guma said it just tastes like ordinary vanilla ice cream. To me, I think the architectures in Amsterdam are way more fascinating. I have something very interesting to share with you guys. If you look at that angle, you can see that this house is leaning this way. It's leaning this way, towards where the camera is. And also, over there, do you see the 1, 2, 3, 4? Do you see the fifth house on that row? It looks like it's leaning towards the right. Why are the houses in Amsterdam wonky? It's because they suffered foundation problems.
Centuries ago, Amsterdam is not much more than a fishing village on the River Amstel. It is located in the middle of a marsh, so if you had built a stone house, it would have sunk before you were even back from the coffee shop. They solved this by driving long wooden poles into the peatland until they hit a firm layer of sand beneath the peat. Pole by pole, Amsterdam grows into a popular seaport.
With water levels in Amsterdam being raised and lowered, as are regulated by the flood control system, the wood posts are susceptible of rotting as they are periodically exposed to air. This, of course, could cause or increase uneven settling of Amsterdam houses and buildings. Amsterdam has a large collection of canals and dividing the city of Amsterdam into approximately 90 mini islands. Amsterdam ferries provide essential free connections across the river IJ for pedestrians, cyclists and mopeds.
Right now guys, we are going inside the ferry cruise. We're gonna take this ferry to the other side. We don't need to pay.
These blue and white ferries are directed behind Amsterdam Central Station, providing a frequent and free service across the waters to and from Amsterdam Noord and NDSM. By the way, do you guys know that the Dutch are the world's tallest population? No wonder they look giant to me. Since the weather is quite unsettled, we decided to head back. I'm counting now. How many seconds we've been on this? Oh my gosh, you're just distracted. And that's for my day two in Holland. On the third day, we will travel to Rotterdam and visit the famous World Heritage Kinderkerk. So stay tuned and bye-bye.